The Old Man and the Sea is the story of an old Cuban fisherman, Santiago, who has been unlucky, is not being able to catch any fish for 84 days. On the 85th day, he succeeds in striking a giant Merlin. The fish is 18 feet long, 2 feet longer than the skiff in which Santiago is sailing. The fish starts towing the boat far into the sea because it does not surface until it tires. The fish does not surface for that day, that night, the next day, and the next night. On the morning of the third day, Santiago succeeds in killing the fish. He sets sail for the return journey. On the way, the smell of the blood oozing out of the heart of the Marlin attacks sharks, and Santiago loses his harpoon in his encounter with the sharks. He kills as many as he can with his improved harpoon, club, and oar, but they are too many and too powerful for him. Even though Santiago has not slept for two nights and survived only on raw fish and a bottle of water, he wages a heroic war against the sharks. In this struggle, he loses almost all the weapons, and in the dark, the sharks devour all the meat of the Merlin. Santiago is left with the skeleton of the fish. When he returns to the island, he carries his mast on his shoulders to the shack where he sleeps with his face downwards and his arms stretched. The next day, Manolin, the boy, who admires Santiago, sees him sleeping, and he cries to see that his hands are bleeding and the old man is almost on the verge of death. Santiago wakes up and makes plans for the future, but he is powerless to do anything. Something broke in the chest during the struggle against the sharks, and it is not certain whether he would survive. The Old Man and the Sea depicts the heroism of a Cuban fisherman, Santiago, who ventures into the deep sea alone and succeeds in hooking a huge Marlin. He struggles with the fish, and after 2 days and nights of hunger and hard fight, he rows it towards the shore. The sharks get smell of the blood oozing out of the Merlin and sets upon his prize. Santiago begins his struggle with the sharks, but the struggle is futile because they are too many and too powerful. Santiago, half dead with exhaustion, throws home the skeleton of the fish. The biggest Merlin ever waited there. The novel records the heroic struggle of Santiago. He is a tragic hero who carries on his fight with his opponents relentlessly. He is defeated but not destroyed. The hero does not accomplish anything materially but obtains an insight into his own identity and passes on the unique experiment to the world. He gains a heroic teacher in his heroic fight. Thank you.